This is a preview of my book, Orff Adventures for Children, and this is a book for teachers who use the Orff-Shulwerk approach in teaching music to children. It doesn't have any Carl Orff music in it. It's original music, or it's arrangements of public domain work, folk songs, etc. Anyway, the music that you'll see in here in this book is music that I use at school, and it's student tested, and I have really good results by using it. But I won't go through every item in here. Of course, that'd be defeat the purpose of having a book for you. But I will share a little bit about what's in the book. There's my table of contents. It's Come to the Circus is a body percussion piece. It's it has different rhythms involved in it. It's basically a two-part thing that you can use in several different ways. Jazz It Up is a little jazzy body percussion piece that also works as an instrumental piece. That's the thing you find out by using the Orff approach, is that once you learn a poem or a rhyme, you can do all kinds of things with it. Black Bats is also a speech piece, but it turns quickly into a percussion piece, and you can use it several different ways. Gator in the Kitchen is probably the favorite song in here from students. It's an original song I wrote. It's my attempt at writing Cajun music, but and I'll play a little excerpt from that. Hoppo Squirrel, folk song, Can't Dance Josie, and Rain Rain Go Away, Rocky Mountain, and there's a hymn also in here, How Firm a Foundation. And they're also included in here are some things from my blog that's on my website, and of course it does have links to it. And the book is available as a book, a physical book, and it's also available as an e-book, a Kindle book. Now, this is Black Bats, and in my book I also have ways of having you teach the piece and have that spelled out. And it's just a little poem. You could use it at Halloween, or we don't have to. You could use it any time because it doesn't say anything about Halloween. It's about bats. And so the poem is, they teach it first, black bats everywhere, flying under bridges, gliding over ridges, eating insects on their way, heading home at the break of day. I wouldn't take it any faster than that. You want to teach the poem first. You can have it, the words projected, or you can just teach it. They can learn it and have it break it down after you've said it a few times. And then you can have them learn it. They'll learn it without even seeing it written out. Then what I like to do is turn it into a little body percussion piece. And I do this way. The top line, the top word phrase is black bats everywhere. Well, that can be done on the fingers. Finger snaps. Black bats everywhere. And the other part pretty much has to be on the pat because it moves around a little bit. Flying under bridges, gliding over ridges. Third part is a stamp with your feet, eating insects on their way. And the last part is clapping, heading home at the break of day. So you can go through it with them and have them say it with the body percussion and learn it all that way, and then it can just make a body percussion piece that everybody's doing together, which would sound like this. You could have them do it in four parts. And then I would divide the groups into four parts, and you could give them a different percussion instrument. You want that flying under bridges, gliding over ridges, something that could be easily played. You could use sticks and play it on hand drums, or you could play it on a djembe, something that can play those 16th notes. The other ones can be played on about anything, percussion-wise. But you'd have one group play maybe on tambourines, other group play on hand drums, third group can play. The stamping part could be a bass drum, or it could be a wood block. Wood block is really good for that flying under bridges, gliding over ridges part. I like it there. And then heading home at the break of day, everybody could play that one. You could have three groups, or you could have another group end it. Well, after that, you could perform all parts together. And that's when you have the students help you out on how, getting ideas on how you want to present this piece. You could present it as a canon. You could do it in canon. Everybody playing the whole thing, but taking turns on the entrances coming in. You could play it not on a canon. You could play it in an ABA form, like you could do it everybody playing the individual parts the first time. The second time, you could have someone play a completely different part. You could make up a thing about bats or night or Halloween and have that being a part that you could play. Black bats are so scary. Black bats are so scary. It could be two different phrases and have somebody play that in the middle, then go back to playing it again. And the third time, you could play it all together, or you could still play it in the groups. It's just so many different ways you can treat this piece, and it's really a lot of fun. They enjoy doing it and playing it after they learn the little poem. So that's just one of the body percussion. I call it body percussion, but it turns into a musical piece. You can actually, besides using non-pitched percussion, you could actually have, say the finger snaps. That could be played on xylophone using a pentatonic setup. You could play it on xylophone. You could play the whole thing on xylophones. or on glockenspiels. Again, Orff doesn't limit you. You just can do a whole lot of things. And you can have people act it out. You could have a dance part in the middle of this thing. Gosh, I love it. I love it a lot. Well, let's go on here and see what else I can show you in this preview. Nothing to see here, okay? Okay, not too interesting. And dedication. Let's see, to God be the glory. More about this book, and there's my email address if you need to email me on something, you have a question. But let's see, let's go here. I said I'd do something about Gator in the Kitchen. I'll do that and then be through with this preview. Now, I've got a little song called Gator in the Kitchen, and I teach it very much the same way. I would teach the words first, and then I teach them the song, teach them the singing part, because it's 'cause I have them sing the song as well as play the parts on the song. So you could do that. And it's really simple. I use this for third grade. And they like I said, they really enjoy this piece. I've got a simple bass drone going on in the bass xylophone, or you could play it on contrabass bars. Boom, 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 do so. Anyway, then I have my alto xylophone. Bum, 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 bum. And then I've got, I don't have the instrument listed on here now that I see, because it doesn't really matter. It's really cool to play it on glockenspiels. It's actually what I, or just if you really want to chomp, get that bass bar and play that thing, contra bass bar, have them play that on the C, on the chomp chomp. That's actually what they like doing the best.
Then let's see, the next part of the piece, it's pretty much the same thing, goes on. And then I've got a B part to it. I want to play just a little bit of the piece. And this is some third graders finishing up singing the first part and playing a little bit. I'm playing this off my iPhone, so I'm sure the tone will be really great for this, but here we go. That's the bass part, B part. And you can add other drum parts, percussion parts to it. Eventually, what happens is we speed the tempo up quite a bit. And actually, we start swinging the eighth notes. And it starts sounding a little bit more Cajun-ish. And you can add a washboard to that if you want to. And in the back, and it'll sound a little bit more like a Cajun piece of music. Anyway, that's Gator in the Kitchen. I hope you enjoyed the preview. The book is available on Amazon.com, or you can go to my website and get it from CreateSpace. Either way, it will work. Thank you so much. I hope you'll try the book out. And when you do, if you do, you can always email me with your questions about how to perform some of the pieces or how to teach them. I'm there to do it. I'm a teacher. That's what I'm doing. And I just want to help you out. So thanks for listening. And that's the end of my preview for Orff Adventures for Children.